Experiment 6. The 8284 clock generator. The aim of this experiment is to start the first phase of designing a single board 8086 microcomputer system. This phase involves making the basic connections of the 8086 microprocessor in minimum mode and interfacing the 8284 clock generator. Open the 8284 clock generator file. You can download the initial schematic design from the link provided in the description of this video. Connect the crystal terminals to pins 17 and 18 of the clock generator. Schematic design. You need to complete the schematic design by adding the following devices. 1. 510 ohm resistor. 2. 10k ohm resistor. 3. Push button. 4. Capacitor primitive. 5. Diode. Click on the library drop-down menu to pick parts from the library and include them into your schematic design. Go to the devices list and pick the 510 ohms resistor. Place two instances of the 510 ohms resistor on your schematic and connect them to the terminals of the crystal. Connect the other side of the 510 ohms resistor to ground. In order to select the crystal as the source of input frequency, connect pins 13 and 14 of the clock generator to ground. Since we are using a single clock generator in our project, synchronization with other clock generators is not required. Therefore, we connect pin 1, the synchronization pin, to ground. Next, we will implement the reset circuit. Pick a push button from the devices list and place it on your schematic. Connect one terminal of the push button to ground, as shown. Pick a capacitor from the devices list and place it on your schematic. pick a 10K resistor from the devices list and place it on your schematic. Connect the resistor and capacitor to the second terminal of the push button, as shown. Connect the other terminal of the resistor to the power. Connect the other terminal of the capacitor to ground. Pick a diode from the devices list and place it on your schematic. Connect the diode to the reset circuit, as shown. Connect the output of the reset circuit to the reset input of the clock generator, pin 11. Double-click on the capacitor model and change its value to 10 microfarad. Now, click on the instrument button to show the instruments list. From there, pick an oscilloscope and place it on your design sheet. Next, connect the outputs of the clock generator to the oscilloscope channels as shown. Run the simulator to monitor and compare the three outputs of the clock generator. Adjust the time scale of the oscilloscope until you see the three signals clearly. Notice that the OSC signal has the same frequency as the crystal. The frequency of the CLK signal is 1/3 of the frequency of the crystal, with 33% duty cycle. The frequency of the PCLK signal is 1/6 of the frequency of the crystal, with 50% duty cycle. Next, we will measure the minimum reset time, that is the charging time of the capacitor, using analog analysis. Choose the probe mode menu and select voltage probe from the probes list and connect it to the output of the reset circuit as shown. Double-click the voltage probe and give it a name of your choice. Choose the graph mode menu and select analog analysis from the list and place it on your schematic as shown. To add the reset signal to the analog analysis, pick the voltage probe and drop it on the analog analysis window, as shown. Double-click the analog analysis window and modify the stop time to 200 milliseconds. And uncheck the initial DC solution box as shown. Double-click the capacitor model and change the initial conditions by typing IC equals 0 volt in the other properties box, as shown. Click the spacebar to start the simulation and wait until the analysis is complete. Double-click the title bar of the analog analysis window to show the analysis results. The analog analysis simulation shows that the capacitor charge will reach 2.5 volt after 69.5 milliseconds.